Finally, I'm going to revise all the concepts again. And please pay attention very carefully. Still, you have any doubt, you can unmute yourself and you can ask questions. Okay. I'm starting the very first topic for revision. We have the basic and the structural tags, HTML. Head. Inside the head, we have title tag. That is used to enclose the title of the web page. The title given inside the title tag will not be displayed in the browser window. It will be shown in the title bar of the browser window. Okay. And here I close the head tag. The HTML tag marks the beginning and the ending of the HTML document. Right. And head tag is used to define the style descriptions and the title that you are using in the web page, followed by the next structural tag, that is the body tag. Okay, the body tag is the tag which encloses the actual content of the web page, right? So here I'm taking the first attribute of body tag, that is the BG color. BG color stands for background color. It is used to specify the color in the background of the web page. Clear? I'm giving the background color gray. Now there are two types of tags, container tag and empty tag. Container tags are those tags that are having both opening and closing tag. But structural empty tags are those tags which have only opening but no closing. Right in front of you, I have typed four tags. All these four tags, no doubt, are structural tags, but these four tags are container tag also. They have opening as well as closing, right? Now inside the body tag, you can see I have given the attribute BG color. What is the role of attribute? Attribute specifies certain properties for that particular tag, right? Every attribute has a name, equal to sign, and the value of attribute. The value of attribute is given by equal to sign, right? If you want to specify the color of the text, suppose you want to display your text in red color, then you can take the text attribute of body tag and you can specify the value here, red. Now gray is the background color of the entire web page and red is the color of the text which will be displayed in the web page. Clear? Then I am taking the most prominent heading tag, heading one or heading element one, right? Now H1 is the highest size, prominent size. Whenever you want to specify the headings, prefer to take H1, right? Now the text which is enclosed in H1 will be bold, right? And you can specify the attribute of heading element align. Heading element H1, H2 till H6. All the heading elements, they have only one attribute that is called align. And align attribute can take left, right, center, and justify value. Clear? I'm writing here the heading HTML basics. This is my heading and here I close the heading element tag. All the heading elements, they are container tags. H1 is the highest, H6 is the lowest. Am I clear up till here? To those I am clear, please raise your thumb to give your feedback so that I can know how many are attending the lecture sincerely. Chahat, Manmeet, Jia, Vanita, Srishti, All right. Now here I am taking the list, or before that I type one paragraph over here. Now P tag, that is known as the paragraph tag. Paragraph tag is used to make the new paragraph in the HTML web page, right? And like heading elements, paragraph tag also has only one attribute, that is align. And in front of you, you can see I have taken the value justify of align attribute of paragraph tag. So here I type the paragraph, board exams are going to start from 20th November 2021. These are the term one exams and will cover MCQs with respect to each subject. The syllabus has been already covered and students are well prepared for the paper. All the students must contribute 100% dedicated efforts towards their revision part. So this is my paragraph, and here I close the P tag, right? Here I close the paragraph tag. Clear? Now I want to leave one blank line here. So I am giving the BR tag. And here I am taking the list tag. UL. UL stands for unordered list. The first type of list, unordered list. By name, it is very much clear. The list in which items are not ordered. Items are not in proper order. Items are not in proper sequence. Items are displayed in form of bullets, or it is known as bulleted list also. So in order to signify the unordered list, I am taking the UL tag. This UL tag has one attribute called type. And three type of bullets can be used while displaying the list in HTML, disk, square, circle. The default value of type attribute in unordered list is disk, right? Now, in order to represent the items or the options in the list, clear? You have to take li tag. Sorry. Li stands for list item tag. It is an empty tag. No need to close the list item tag. The number of options you want, the number of items you want, the number of times you use the li tag, that is the list item tag. Clear? I am taking here subject's name, English. Maths, Punjabi, Science, Social Science, computer applications in the okay, so these are my subjects, and here I close the unordered list. You can give here one additional heading if you want using the H2 tag. Subjects of okay, clear. Am I clear with the unordered list to everyone? Then here you can take another list, that is OL, ordered list. By name, it is very much clear when items are arranged in proper order, proper sequence. This type of list is also known as numbered list. Right? Because all the options, they are displayed either alphabetically wise, means like ABC or 1, 2, 3 or Roman numerals. The default ordering is 1, 2, 3 in numeric form. I'm taking the type attribute and I'm taking the value small a. Here you can specify the heading. H2 exam first list item PT1 PT2 PT3 Term 1 board three boards Term 2 board. Three board, what term one? Okay. Then here you can close the order list. Let us see the browser view up till here. So I am closing here the body tag. I am closing here the HTML tag. I am saving the web page with the name Final 10D Revision.html. Let us see the browser view. How our web page looks up till here. We have final revision. Yeah. See here. I do one thing, I change the color. Here I close the font tag. Then here again I take the font tag. or better I take the black color only. And here I close the code. Check it. I increase the zoom level. Check it, all of you. Is the browser view clear to everyone? Yes, Saksham, Manjeet, Kartike, browser view visible hai? Then after this, you can add more to your coding by specifying the definition list also. Definition list. Now, definition list is the list in which there are no bullets and no alphabets and no Roman, right? It has a term and the definition of the term. Clear? Like suppose I start the definition list with DL. DL stands for definition list. While creating the definition list, two tags are very essential. One is the DT tag that specifies the term to be defined. Like I'm giving the term here, FTT. Okay, now I'm giving the second tag, DD. DD is known as definition description. Here we provide the definition of the term which we have given in the DT tag. It refers to file transfer protocol and is used to transfer files. Is used to transfer files. Okay. Then another DT you can give here. Telnet. You can specify the definition. It is used to log on to remote computer. Am I clear to all? Then you can close the DL tag. Ye dekho. अब आप यहां पे नोटिस करो, आई हैव चेंज द कलर फॉर सब्जेक्ट्स बाय गिविंग द फॉन्ट टैग. आई हैव चेंज द कलर फॉर द एग्जाम्स यूजिंग द ब्लैक कलर इन द फॉन्ट टैग. हियर आई हैव नॉट यूज द फॉन्ट टैग. सो दिस पैराग्राफ, दिस एरिया, इट हैज टेकन द कलर विच इज गिवन इन द टेक्स्ट एट्रीब्यूट ऑफ बॉडी टैग. क्लियर टू ऑल? Am I clear to all? So up till here, I have revised the basics of HTML. Now you can insert one image here if you want. In order to insert image in the HTML, you have to take img tag. Img tag is an image tag and it is also an empty tag. In order to insert image, you are to take the attribute src. SRC stands for source and it is used to specify the location of the file. Whichever file you want to insert, it is used to store, it is used to specify the location of that particular file. Okay. Audible 10th D. Manveer, Kartike Daksh, Vanita Jia, am I audible now? All right. So in order to specify the location of the file, I am taking the SRC attribute. Here you are to type the whole path. So let us find the image that we want to insert in the web page. Pictures, sample pictures. I am taking this picture, tulips.jpg. I right click on the picture. I choose the properties option. I select the location. I copy paste it. And I paste it here. Then put a slash here and write the image name, tulips.jpg. Okay. Then here you can specify the height equal to 100, width equal to 100 for the image, and close the angle bracket. Please do not close the image tag like this. It is wrong. Image is an empty tag. See here, image has been placed here with the height and width 100. Now image by default is on the left side. Okay. If you add any text along with the image, image is text along the image is bottom aligned by default. मैंने इमेज के साथ एक टेक्स्ट को प्लेस किया तो प्लीज नोटिस इट द टेक्स्ट इंसर्टेड विद रिस्पेक्ट टू द इमेज इज बॉटम अलाइन्ड बाय डिफॉल्ट यू कैन चेंज द अलाइनमेंट इफ यू वांट बाय स्पेसिफाइंग अलाइन एट्रीब्यूट इक्वल टू टॉप सी हियर Text is appearing on the top. Then you can give here middle. Top, middle and bottom. These three type of alignments is with respect to text. Top, middle, bottom. These three type of values of align attribute of image tag is with respect to the text that is inserted along the image. Check it. Okay. Now suppose I give the value right here. Left and right are with respect to the image. Top, middle, bottom are with respect to the text. There is no center value in the align attribute of image tag. Check it. Am I clear? Now see here, where the text is placed when you inserted image on the right side. See the placement of the text with respect to image. Clear to everyone? So that was the revision part of HTML. Okay.